My name is Asad Yaqub, and we're going to take a start with your IELTS speaking. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's take a start. How do you usually contact your friends?
Yeah, mainly I contact my friends through my mobile. Occasionally, I use social media to contact them, like use my WhatsApp or Facebook Messenger or through Instagram, but most of the times I use mobile phone.
Do you often make phone calls?
No, basically, I am an introvert person, so I do not like socializing very much. So most of the times I try to avoid calling people. I try to make my task done by texting them. But if there is a dire need to call them, then I do.
In what ways do you use social media to communicate?
I use WhatsApp to text and to communicate through images like Snapchat. And Instagram also, to text and sending pictures.
All right. Do you ever write letters?
No, you know, this is the 21st century. So I don't think that anybody in this era needs letters to communicate. So no, I do not use letters for communication.
Good. We now move on to IELTS speaking part 2. This is your topic. You have 1 minute to read the topic and write down some notes. Okay, you'll now have to speak on this topic for 1 to 2 minutes.
Yeah, to describe my topic, I would say that I met a person in the train. I was traveling back in 2018 from my hometown, which is Miachanu, to Lahore. I met this lovely lady in the train. She was like 27 to 28 years old. She approached me right at the moment. We hit it off. She also told me that she was studying Harvard Medical at the Harvard Medical School, but she was in Pakistan on the vacation. The conversation was very interesting because I myself am very interested in scholarships. She was studying there on the scholarship. It was a very prestigious scholarship, you know. We hit it off because she told me in detail all about the scholarship and how I can, you know, obtain the scholarship. She described all the details and how I can ace it, how I can appear in the GRE with good marks. She also told me that her professors were very elaborative and cooperative. So it was, on collective, a very intellectual and a nice discussion with her. We enjoyed it until we reached Lahore, our destination. So I kind of remember that day due to her nice and lovely personality.
Okay, thank you very much. We now move on to IELTS speaking part 3. What age group do you think has the best communication skills? Please turn the mic towards you.
I would say that teenagers can communicate very well because they are energetic, they are talkative, and they are more prone to socialize. That's why.
In your opinion, has technology improved the way we communicate with each other?
No, I don't think so. In my opinion, technology has suppressed the way we can communicate because it has made us very... prone to, suppressing our feelings, in not communicating and, hiding our things and feelings and not communicating very well.
Do you think we have lost any communication skills because of technology?
We can say that because, again, as I have told, that we are not very much, we have not remained very talkative and communicative. Most of the times we spend our time on social media and other entertainment platforms. We do not want to socialize. We do not want to talk to our elders and spend leisure time with them while discussing. So I guess no. Most of the times we spend with them, with ourselves.
All right. It's all good. Overall, your speaking is quite fine. Just try to focus compound ideas, compound sentences. As you are moving on in speaking part 2, I noticed you made 5-6 sentences with almost the same structure and without connecting these sentences. So try to use the words like moreover, additionally, by this I mean, furthermore, right? And then as you're already using first of all, secondly, finally. So when these things will be added, your talk is going to be even more, it's going to be better than it is now. Looking at your overall performance in all 4 skills of the marking criteria, I would give you a 7 band.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.